Hi guys, I'm back with another quick update video. I'm gonna kind of make this one fast, but pretty much in this video I'm gonna be talking about my pre-op appointment that I had yesterday. So I'm just gonna jump right into it. So yesterday I had the pre-op appointment. Basically when I first got there, I met with my surgeon staff member or his assistant, and she pretty much gave me a whole packet paperwork that I needed to sign off. This is what it looks like. I'm not sure if everyone's pre-op appointment was the same or if they got this much documentation, but pretty much this whole packet gives you like everything that you need to know about your procedure. It gives you what to expect, it gives you what to do before, and it also gives you a list of medications to avoid before and after surgery. Now this is a long list. I think there's another page. This is like a long list. And this is all medical termed medication, so I don't know what the hell these mean. But I'm pretty sure that I probably don't take this medication anyway. But pretty much it just tells you what to avoid. Herbal supplements and dietary pills and antidepressant medicine, medications. So yeah, this is basically what the packet is. I've read through this packet like 3 times already, just because it's always good to know what's going on. So this is what the packet was for. Also it gave me a list of medications a list of things to take before you have surgery. It gave me a list of medications that I needed to buy, and I filled up my prescriptions. For anyone who's having this procedure done, make sure you have your prescriptions filled before surgery. Even if your surgery is like 2 weeks from now, just have them filled so that way you don't have to worry about it. Mine, I think, is in 5 days. It's on the 27th. I believe today is the 22nd, so it's in 5 days. Crazy, right? So I got 4 of my prescriptions filled. I'll go through the list of the medications in a little bit. And then also, I'm gonna start my packet. I guess you can take like multivitamins and vitamin C, and it says that you should avoid vitamin E. So pretty much what I did was I went to Walmart. I got the little generic brand, the Women's One Daily. And this is like a multivitamin. I think it was like $4, and it's 100 tablets, and you're supposed to take one daily. And usually, preferably with a meal, that's what it says. So I just started taking this today. So yeah, if you guys are having this done, it's the Women's, I hope you can see this. So I'm going to do the hand behind the light thing that people do in their videos. the Women's One Daily Pill. You can find it at Walmart in your, I think it like has vitamin aisle. You know where you get the little medications from. Yep, you can do that. That's what I have. So, yes, after I was done filling out the paperwork and signing everything off, I had to go across the street to do lab work. And basically, my light went out, guys. Sorry. I don't know why that just happened. So, basically, I would not have the light on, but it's kind of dark anyway. But after I had my, did all the paperwork, I went across the street and did some lab work, and there I did a urinalysis. A pee test, or whoever doesn't know what a urinalysis is, basically you pee in a cup. And then they did blood work just to check for HIV antibodies or stuff like that, just to be sure everyone's safe. So that's what I did. That was pretty much all that it was for my pre-op appointment. It really wasn't much. I was kind of disappointed that I didn't get to meet with the surgeon. I'm not sure if you meet with the surgeon before you have surgery. I'm assuming you do, but he was out of town with another patient. I guess he had to do he was doing another surgery somewhere, so that's why I didn't get to meet with him. I was kind of bummed out about that, just because I did have a lot of questions. But then again, there is time for questions before surgery, so I'm kind of happy about that. So yeah, now I'm just going to go through the medications, and excuse me if I'm pronouncing these the wrong way. I took a medical terminology class like a year ago, but I just don't know how to pronounce certain things. So the first thing that I have to take is Zantac. And I take this the day before surgery and the morning of surgery. So I take this the night before and upon arrival. So I should probably take this in the morning. I'm not sure when my surgery time is. They call you the day before to let you know what time you are expected to arrive at the hospital. So this is what I have. Zantac. I'm probably going to look this up just to see like what the hell what I'm putting into my body. Then I have Valium. I have to take this before bedtime, the night before surgery. And then I have Keflex. I'm not sure what the Keflex is for. I'm guessing it's for pain because it has a lot of tablets in here. Quantity of 16. So I have to take one capsule by mouth 4 times daily. I think this is for like infections to reduce my risk of getting infections. I think that's what it's for. And then I have I think I'm saying this right. I feel like I'm not. But this is for pain. So this is obviously going to be after surgery. And I take this tablet, take one tablet by mouth every 4 hours for pain. So this is going to eliminate the pain. That's good. So that is all that happened at my pre-op appointment. So now that I'm done talking about that, I want to talk about like the actual surgery itself. Now guys, my surgery is in 5 days and I am very, very nervous. And sorry if I look kind of off today. I don't feel good. So anyway, I'm really nervous about the appointment or about the surgery just because I've never had surgery done before. I've never been under the knife. All I've really done is just been to a doctor's appointment. So, yeah. So, I'm just going to talk about, like, how scared I am. I'm very nervous. The one thing that I'm really nervous about, and I know I probably shouldn't be thinking like this. Sometimes I can be a negative thinker. Like, I always kind of think about the worst of situations instead of thinking about the positive, but I am really afraid of death. I know I might sound crazy, but in the packet they say one of the complications after surgery or what can happen during surgery is death, and it's very rare that it's happened, but I'm really nervous. I know nothing really is going to, like, you know, it's going to happen, but I'm just really nervous. And I'm sure it's natural. And then also my other worry is my reaction to the anesthesia. I don't know. I don't know how. I usually don't have a bad reaction to any type of medicine that I take. So I'm not sure. Like, I don't know. I'm just really nervous. So if anyone's watching this video who's been through it before, just if you can kind of just give me, you know, some advice and uplift my spirits, because I'm really scared. Like, I promise you, I probably will cry when I get to the surgery center next week Tuesday. I'm really nervous about that. That's really scary. So, I've been looking up YouTube videos about anesthesia, and so far from what I'm seeing, it doesn't look bad. But then again, everyone is different, and I just don't want to be that rare person like that. That 0.9% person, you know, the 99.9% person that actually goes through, you know, has a reaction, a bad reaction to the anesthesia. But I think I should be okay. So that's what I'm really nervous about. So I think that's all that I wanted to talk about. If anyone who's watching this video, like I said, who's having this procedure done, just please leave your comments or questions down below, and I'll try to answer them the best way that I can. Like I said, when I do have the surgery done, I'll have some video footage of before I go into surgery on the day and then after, of course. And I'll try my best to upload those. And then also, people, from my before and after pictures, you can go on to realself.com. I was actually able to get the link. It's supposed to be on my little description box on the left side of your screen. Yeah, on the left side of your screen. And it's realself.com. You can go there and view my before and after pictures. And also, ladies, you can also go on that website too. It's a really good website. And it's not just about women who have breast reductions. It's just about any procedure. Like if you're doing a breast lift, breast augmentation, if you're doing liposuction, a mommy makeover, a tummy tuck, just any type of procedure, that is a really good website because there are people on there who share their real stories about what really happened. So that way you kind of don't feel alone. So yes, ladies, make sure you go to Real Self, or ladies or gentlemen, because men have breast reductions too. And not even just for male breast reductions, just for any type of procedure. Go to realself.com, share your story. There's also doctors on there who, there's actual real doctors on the website who actually answer questions. So just check out the website. And don't forget, if you're watching this video, subscribe to my channel and I'll subscribe back. So I am going to leave now because I don't have anything else to talk about, and I will keep going on and I probably won't make any sense. So, like I said, any questions, leave it down below. I can't get my paper in here. Leave your questions down below and I will answer them. So, yes, I will see you guys in a few days with another update if I have one. If not, then I'll see you guys after my surgery. Wish me luck. Okay.
Bye, download guys. Allow me to say, fuck it. I ain't got it over right now.